Let us do some experiments to understand pulse code modulation and demodulation. We all know the first thing which is required into pulse code modulation is you need a message signal, you need an analog signal. So here we have a function generator which is giving at this point 1 kilohertz sine wave. So we can see that this is a 1 kilohertz sine wave which we are getting at this particular point. I can change its amplitude, so we can vary its amplitude. So this is a 1 kilohertz sine wave which is my analog signal, and I am going to encode it through a PCM technique. So now what's next? The next is that we need to connect this analog signal to a sample and hold circuit. So this is our sample and hold circuit input. So I am just connecting this 1 kilohertz sine wave to this sample and hold circuit. So this is a sample and hold circuit input. This is the sampling frequency. So if we test the output of sample and hold, then we can see that this is the sample and hold circuit's output. So this is the sample and hold circuit output of the input signal which we have fed into sample and hold circuit. Now what is next? Each sample which is held by this sample and hold will be converted into a 8-bit digital data by A to D converter. So this is a A to D converter, 8-bit A to D converter, which is converting each sample from sample and hold into a corresponding 8-bit data. The D1 to D7 are indicated through an LED. The most least significant digit is not displayed because it keeps on continuously varying. Now we know that the A to D converter's job is to convert each sample into corresponding 8-bit data, and that 8 bits are available parallelly at the output of A to D converter. From here, it enters into a parallel to serial shift register. So this is a parallel to serial shift register. 8 bits from A to D converter are entering into the shift register parallelly, and one by one the bits are coming out serially at this point, and we are getting here the pulse code modulated data at the modulator's output. So now this is our pulse code modulated data. We can see that this is our pulse code modulated data. Let me show it on this digital storage oscilloscope. This is the pulse code digital modulated data at this point. If we vary it, the data will vary. So this is our pulse code modulated data. Now let's connect this pulse code modulated data to the demodulator circuit. So now let's connect it to a demodulator. So I am just connecting this PCM data to a demodulator. Now we know that in a pulse code demodulation, the data is receiving at demodulation circuit serially. So this data, we had seen that the data is coming serially, and then it gets entered into a shift register. So now this is the first block, is shift register. The data is coming serially into this shift register, and this shift register is converting the serial data into a parallel 8-bit data. So these parallel 8 bits are going into the D2A converter. So this D2A converter is accepting 8-bit parallel data from this shift register, and it converts that 8 bits into a corresponding analog signal, which is nothing but a sampled output of our input signal. So it is as good as same as sample and hold. So if we see at this point, we can see that this is the same sampled output. So this D2A converter is converting each sample's 8-bit data into an analog signal. So this sample and hold circuit signal is coming at this point, and we know that if we apply a filter at this point, then this filter will remove the unwanted or the high frequency sample signals from the signal, and we will derive our original signal of 1 kilohertz or 2 kilohertz which we connected here. So I am just, this is a filter we are connecting at this point. We can see that we are getting the same signal which we have fed at to the pulse code modulator input. If I vary its amplitude, you can see that the amplitude of the received signal at pulse code demodulation, that is also varying. So this is how a PCM modulation and demodulation works. Now you will be surprised that all LEDs are glowing at this point. So for example, if the clock at which this A to D converter, the clock at which the shift register is working, if I lower down the clock's frequency, probably we can show or we can see the signals flow. So let me do the clock frequency to 1.9 Hz and 1.9 Hz at PCM modulation, demodulation. You can see that the data is coming 1 and all 0. That 1 and all 0 latched into this, and now it is coming serially out. You can see that 1 and all 0. Now this 1 and all 0 is latched into it, and now it is serially coming out. This data is coming here serially in 1 and all 0. It is parallelly out here, and then the corresponding signal is being generated. So this is how the signal is being converted. The data is coming here into the A to D converter, 1 and all 0. It is parallelly out to a shift register. From here it is coming out serially. That serially comes data into the shift register. Now it is going parallelly out, so the data will come here 1 and all 0, and this 1 and all 0 is converted into the sampled signal, analog signal, and it is filtered out, and we are getting the sine wave.